Hello everyone, what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be managing files with Dreamweaver. Now you should have already done the FileZilla lesson, where you created a folder on the server with your name on it, and we're going to be using that folder in Dreamweaver. Let's pop open Dreamweaver first. Closes the welcome screen, we don't need that. So what Dreamweaver does amazingly well is this sites feature. So let's create a site. Let's go site. New site. Let's name the site something that describes it, like my portfolio, the portfolio of so and so. Have your name in it. I'm going to call it, because I'm recording the Dreamweaver Clinic. And the local site folder is the folder on your hard drive that you're saving your site to. So in this case, let's point it towards that folder you've been working in. In my case, it's on the desktop. The folder you've been dumping all your HTML files into. That is your local site folder. And then we have to set a server to upload this local site folder to. So when the server is on the left, hit the plus sign. The server name, let's call it DMA. Connect using SFTP, not regular FTP, secure file transfer protocol. The SFTP address is dma.sjsu.edu. The username, and the port is not important, it's automatically filled in. The username and password will be supplied to you by your professor. I currently have a username. Once you've got that entered, get that a test. Connected successfully. If it doesn't work, double check your username and password, your SFTP address. The root directory is capital S sites / and the name of the folder that you created in the FileZilla lesson. And the web URL, we're not going to change this right now. We don't have to worry about that for the sake of time. Let's just skip that. So double check, pause the video here and double check everything. And even give it a test if you're not sure. Save that. We're done here. Save this. So now what we have is the local view on the right here. This is the folder on our hard drive. It's the same as this folder here, the one I've opened already, the one I've been dumping all my portfolio projects into, just viewed within Dreamweaver. And we can change the local view to remote server, and it connects to the server, and this is the folder that we specified on the server. This is the folder that you created during the FileZilla lesson. There's nothing there right now. And we're going to go over the first amazing thing about Dreamweaver, which is synchronize. So we're going to hit the Synchronize button right here. And it gives us some options. We want to synchronize the entire site. And we have a couple of options here. Put newer files to remote. Get newer files from remote. Get and put newer files. And I'm going to choose Get and put newer files. What this does is it grabs the files, it gets the files off the server, and it puts the files on our hard drive onto the server. So it makes them identical. So hit preview and you'll see what I'm talking about. So the server is lacking all these files, so we have to put these onto the server. And that's perfect. Hit OK. And you'll see, once it's done, here we go. The server, the remote view, looks just like our local view. So another very powerful feature of Photoshop, let's double click on one of our projects and I'm going to make a change. I'm going to change this Project 1 thumb. I'm going to change this to Project 1 mini. How about that? And if you hit enter, you see Dreamweaver knows that you've made a change. It's been watching your actions and it knows all the files that reference that Project 1 small.jpg. And it's saying here that Project 1 is calling for this file. Should we update the information on Project 1 as well? Yes, yes, we should. Update that. So now you see Project 1 Thumb has been changed to Project 1 Mini, just like I changed it down here. And that's pretty automatic. It'll do that for as many files as are calling for that image. It'll do that for anything. You always want to double check it. You always want to double check in a browser what your site looks like. But that works great. And another great feature about Dreamweaver is you always want to watch up here in the title bar, because this asterisk here, this asterisk means that I haven't saved. So if I go to File, Save, That'll save my HTML document. Asterisk is gone. And now we can synchronize again. So if we hit synchronize again, we want to synchronize the entire site. Direction, let's get input again. And let's hit preview. So now what do we see? We see we have to put these two files on the server because we've changed them. And we see that it wants to get this image here. And the reason it's doing this is because it thinks that there's a difference between Project 1 Mini and Project 1 Thumb. It just knows them by name. And so it noticed that we don't have Project 1 Thumb on our hard drive, but we do have it on the server. So when we get put, it wants to make them the same. So it wants to get this and put it on our hard drive. But we're done with Project 1 Thumb. We don't need it anymore. So we can actually change what Dreamweaver does down here. We can just go ahead and delete it. So we're going to be putting these two updated files, and we're going to be deleting this old file name that's stuck on the server, because we don't need it anymore. Hit OK. Do you really want to delete this? Yes, Dreamweaver, yes I do. So now, if we go to the remote view, we see exactly the same as our local view. And we can test that. We can go to our web browser, and we can go to the URL for our website, and we see here, here's the URL for the website that I'm working on right now, Project 1, and here's the change. If I view the source, Apple U, you can see that it does indeed say Project 1 Mini instead of Project 1 Thumb as it was originally. So we've successfully updated the site, and we've double-checked it on the web to make sure that everything works. And so this is kind of how you want to work. You want to be making files, changing files, synchronizing, and double-checking everything on the web. This is exactly the same thing we did in FileZilla, only now with Dreamweaver we have a couple more intelligent options that help us along the way. So next lesson we're going to be going over editing a site with Dreamweaver, and that's going to be an awesome time as well. Thank you very much for watching, and keep practicing good file structure.